Hello guys, Flying Dutchy here. Welcome to our next part in our tutorial for complete beginners in EU4. So this is the third video that we are doing war stuff. I hope you're not tired because it's a lot of information, but we are getting there. We are having almost fully occupied Granada, as you can see. We have a high chance of, we have a chance to 14% chance to make this province surrender, and we always have a chance to increase our progress. So, we will be fine here. And we are trying to land our troops here now in Tunis, in the capital of Tunis. It's also called Tunis. It's their best province, and yeah, maybe we will conquer it actually. I don't know yet. But let's land our troops in Tunis. We have 5,000 cavalry and 5,000 infantry. Cavalry is the strongest at the start of the game, and that's why I put them over here. It takes a long time to unload the troops, as you can see. We're still improving with the Pope, with Portugal. Yeah, we don't really have to do all of this anymore. Let's improve with Austria, one of our allies. Get them to 200 opinion. At least all our diplomats are now at work. Now, when this army is over half of its trajectory, it will get a lock, just like always, and will be landlocked. There we go. It's now black. The arrow is black. We cannot stop this movement anymore. They will land in Tunis. Now, it's nice that we have our fleet here, because we are already blockading the port. So we will have the -2 penalty will be gone, because we will blockade the port. And there we go. We are now in Tunis. We have a -42% at the start. When I click on Tunis, you can see that we don't have a -2. We have 0. So all the bonuses is now -1 roll. So the maximum roll we can do is 15. Or not. No, 13 I mean. The roll goes from 1 to 14. -1 is 13. The highest modifier we can get is a food shortage. When we roll a 12 or a 13 in total. So, yeah. We do get attrition, because we are sieging down the province. So we get 1% over 10,000. And that is 100 troops a month dying here by sieging down the province. Now we gain 263. So a lot of our manpower that we gain is gonna get lost by just sieging one fort. What you can do again, as I did in my war in Granada, is split the army. Especially your cavalry, because it's more expensive, and move them somewhere else. This is risky, because when their army comes, you don't want to have your army split. Now, luckily for us, I know where the army of Tunis is. They have 10,000 troops, and they are sitting over here, doing nothing. So I can freely do this now. And keep an eye out for this army. Now, I cannot see it anymore, because my allies and my people in the war are not having vision over the coastline. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to split my fleet and send half of it to the Barbary coast. Not only will you get more war score when you blockade more ports, you also get vision over the provinces adjacent to the sea tile. That's what I'm going to do now. See if they are still there, the 10,000. Yes, they're doing nothing. And we are now blockading 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ports. And that will give us some war score, I think. Yeah, if you blockade their ports, you get war score. And especially for their capital, we get a 10 war score. By just blockading their port. Now we need to watch out for their navy, because they have 9,000 transports here. So we could easily beat their navy over here. Let's have a look at their total navy. They have 10,000 transports, 7,000 galleys, and they are pretty powerful. And some light ships. But some of them are also from Granada. Seven of them are from Granada, who are waiting to be captured by me when we siege the fort. So maybe I should try to fight the 7,000 when we get the siege. I think I'm gonna send 11 ships here to capture the 7,000. I'm gonna send these to the Barbary coast so I can keep fishing over the 10,000. We will lose our siege progress here. As you can see now, we have -2 because we don't blockade the port anymore. But let's do it safe. Let's do it like this. One fleet to see the 10,000 army that is left, and 11,000 to help with the siege progress and capture the 7 boats here. But we have now 35% chance to win in the next roll we get. But we have a decent chance to win the siege. Nope, we did not win, but next roll we have 49%. So I'm gonna wait for the next roll here. In the meantime, we're getting our armies are looting. This one is looting a bit. This one is looting a little bit. And we have a lot of money. Oh yeah, and we need to talk about the technology. So we finally have enough monarch power, military power, to click the first technology. Now, do you remember that we have the institution of the Renaissance spawning? That's still working. And since we are now in 1452, we have a 2% tech penalty to get the next technology. Now, we really want this technology because we get more military tactics. Do you remember that we have 0.5 tactics in Granada as well? Now, this is a huge bonus at the start of the game. If you have tech 4 and your enemy has tech 3, you will be fighting so much better. Also, the land morale bonus is very nice. Gonna actually get the technology for 580 military power. We also have a -5 bonus because one of our neighbors is already having tech 4. Maybe that's Portugal actually. Aragon. No, England. France. France is having tech 4. And we are bordering France over here with this sea tile. And that makes us give -5%. So we have -5, +2, -3% in total. And there's an increase over time as well. So normally at 600 we pay 580. And there we go. We have now the next technology, Pike Square. We have some bonuses. And our armies will fight better. Do you see that the morale bar is now not fully complete? Fully green? Because we have more morale because of our technology. So next month the morale will go up of our armies. We have a higher maximum morale. Are we gonna win the siege? No, we did not win the siege. Still 49%, so we need to wait a bit longer. The Ottomans are going ham. Lithuania is getting wrecked. Who is attacking England here? It's Burgundy, actually. Burgundy is fighting England. The army of Tunis is not moving. Good for us. Now, let's see if we can get the rolls here now. We need to wait 16 days. Hopefully, we will siege down the last province of Granada. There we go. We got all the provinces from Granada. And we killed all their armies. And now we are hopefully killing their fleet. They have nowhere to retreat to, I think. Or they are going to retreat to Tunis. So maybe we are now going to destroy their whole fleet. Let's have a look. They cannot retreat yet. 28th of April, they could retreat. No, they are not retreating. So when you conquered all the provinces, the AI cannot retreat anymore, and we are gonna kill all their fleets. Boom. Two actually remain. I wonder where they will go to. I think they're going to Tunis. Now, we had a bit of damage with one of our ships, so I'm gonna let them repair. Let's see where their ship goes. Where is this ship retreating to? Are they going to Tunis? Maybe they are. Yeah, they're going over here. So they can actually retreat to the enemy ports. That's good to know. What I can do now is send more troops to Tunis. Now, I don't think I have to, and I'm not going to, but if you were a new player, send another 10,000. Combine your fleet again and send 10,000 troops to Tunis. And then you will be victorious in any way. Sorry, I just looked for something, but we're not going to do it, I think. Yeah. So we will keep fighting. Now you can see that we only have 49% war score, not 100. I mean, we killed everything. And that's because Tunis is also in the war. You can see that we have a ticking war score now of 4.8. And we can get 20 war score more by just waiting and controlling the war goal of Granada. If I would have a diplomat, let's send one home. Right click on the one with Portugal for improving relations. Let's wait 4 days. There we go. This is your peace button. And here you can do anything you want for your peace deal. You can click on provinces if you want them. And you can see if the enemy wants to accept or not. So at the moment we can only take 3 or 4 provinces because Tunis is still not out of the war. You can also take money. If you shift right click, you get the full amount of money you can get from this this nation. You can make them revoke their course on other provinces. You can make them annul treaties. For example, I can make them cancel the alliance with Tunis. Now, it's not very helpful if you're going to fully annex a country, then this is not doing anything, so we're not going to click on that. And you can make someone a Castilian. You can make someone your vassal. Just like we tried with Navarra, but we failed. You can only ask for a concede defeat and get a bit of prestige. And you can ask the trade power from your enemies. Now, we want to conquer this whole nation, so all these other things are not doing anything for us. Because they will be gone from the map. So the only thing we want from Granada is taking all his land. And what is this province? This is a province from Tunis, Bizerte. We actually occupied Bizerte, and there are two ways to peace out from a war. You can peace out with the war leader and ask him for anything that you conquered from any nation that you're fighting. So we also can ask Bizerte. Because we conquered this. That is one way you can do it. What you also can do is sue for peace with your other nations first. So we could separate peace Tunis. Now we don't have any war score right now, but later we will get some war score, and maybe we should conquer Tunis. Therefore, we need 23 war score. We're going to talk about this when we are actually going to peace out. And yeah, you can just first peace out Tunis, and then a month later you peace out Granada. That is most of the times the better way to do it. Now, we made Tunis a co-belligerent. Maybe you remember it. We made them a co-belligerent in the war because they did not have allies they could call in. And since we made them a co-belligerent, we could take land from them without too much aggressive expansion. But I will talk about aggressive expansion when we are going to peace out. Let's just keep sieging Tunis now, maybe this fort as well. Remember, forts give you more war scores, so you want to conquer the forts of the enemy. There's not a fort over here in Djerba. I think when we have these three forts, we will have enough war score to peace out Tunis. So I think I'm gonna send over more troops. I'm gonna select all my armies. Make them go to Murcia. And let's transport some of them to Tunis. Now we have an event here. I never lose power most of the time. I just lose my trade power. It's fine. Power is too important. I will wait one monthly tick to repair my fleet. 89%. I'm gonna combine my fleet in Murcia. There we go, with 22 ships here. Select the fleets, group them together. Wait for my armies to arrive in Murcia. And then I will send another 10,000 to Tunis. There we go. We'll group them up in one army. Now we do not have a lot of cavalry, but I will send one cavalry and 9 infantry. With my heir that we want to die, that's why we made them a general, attached to the transport. I'm gonna wait 7 more days because we still need to repair one of our ships. Gonna wait a bit longer. This will go to 99%. There we go. And now we are gonna go to Tunis. Now, since we now occupied this province, you can land them immediately. Do you remember that we had to land our troops from our fleet and that took a long time? But now we control a port, so we can move our fleet into this port and unload the army immediately. Now there are some Granadan ships over here. We will maybe kill. Why are we not fighting that ship? I don't know. That's really weird. I mean, we are still at war with Granada. The 10,000 army is moving, so it will move to here, I think, so we will not be able to see it, where it will go. There we go, and there's my army. Now, the 10,000 here with the siege general, I think I'm gonna put them in Kef. We need 6,000 troops there. So I will put 7,000. So we are sure that we always have enough. And we keep the 8,000 here as a backup if we will get attacked. And we're gonna siege down Kef. But there's one more fort here that we also need 6,000 troops. Let's just send all our armies there. So we are sure about it, that we are gonna win. Now when this army arrives here, you can see the neighboring provinces from where your army is. So we can now see this and we can see these two. So we have a good vision about the Tunis army now. Now, oh, there they are. I'm gonna try to kill the Granada fleet first. Maybe we can capture 2 lightships. That would be very nice. And then we'd pick the other 10,000 troops. Well, actually, we now won the siege of Tunis. So we could maybe move our army over here, but I think that is not possible. Let's have a look. No. I could move it over here to Sfax, but I cannot move my army to these two provinces. Now, why is that? There is a fort in Kef, and all the neighboring provinces are influenced by this fort. We cannot move further than one province that is adjacent to the fort. Now, this province is adjacent to the fort, so if we want to move further than this province, we need to conquer this fort first. That's why we cannot move to these provinces. So we need to wait for this one to be completed, and then we could move over land to this fort. There's a strait here with these crosses, so we could move our army to this fort. So we cannot do it right now, so I'm gonna stop the movement and I'm gonna use my ships. What is this? The House of the Trastamara, which is our dynasty, is shaken. we can lose 5 legitimacy or 5 prestige. Now, we have a very high legitimacy. What is 5 points of legitimacy? That's almost nothing. So I will just lose a bit of legitimacy. And we get it back every year with 0.45 automatically because we have some royal marriages with our allies. And we have a bit of power projection and we have a bit of prestige. Now the AI is now running away, as you can see, to the open seas, so I'm not gonna follow them. I'm gonna return my fleet to Tunis and I'm gonna send the troops to this fort. So it's a level 2 fort. That means we need 6,000 or preferably 7,000 troops there. I'm gonna select 2 more infantry. And I'm gonna put them on this fort. Now they have 18,000 fleet Tunis, so we have to watch out here. And galleys as well. I'm not sure if we can win this. I mean, we do have heavy ships. Heavy ships are very powerful. What is Tunis gonna do? Are they gonna run away? I think so. There we go. Gonna group them up. I think I'm gonna use my general. He's not helping with the siege bonus. There's no siege pips, but he can be good when fighting. So, gonna put him on the boat. We're gonna send our boats to the Gulf of Gabes, which is just in our supply limit. We have 147 of 150, so we do not get attrition. When you move them over here, it's too far away from our home, and then your fleet will get attritioned. There we go, our fleet arrived. Let's send them to the fort. It's gonna take some time. In the meantime, I'm gonna split this army and carpet siege a bit over here in these two provinces. Not gonna move him too far away, because the 10,000 army can come. And then we need to be able to reinforce the 7,000 with the 6,000 troops. Tunis wants to peace out. The AI will send you peace deals. Normally you never accept them. You just want to make your own peace. Now let's have a look what they want to give us. They want to give money. They want to give 315 ducats. Nope. I'm gonna take a couple of provinces from you, so go away. Go away, Tunis. Hey, we have another pop-up for our technology. We can get Diplo technology level 4, and that makes us get our first building, the marketplace. It's we have a penalty because we don't have the institution, but our neighbors do have the technology, so I am gonna click this one for 580 Diplo power. These bonuses are something else. Now you can see we get the marketplace. We are now 1 year ahead of time. Also in our military technology, we are 1 year ahead of time. There is a certain time where you should pick your technology. Now, we are now 1 year ahead. We don't have enough points to get the next technology to level 5. But if we would have enough Diplo power right now, then the technology will be 5% more expensive. Or normally 10%, but we have a neighbor that is having tech 5, I guess. So it makes it 5%. If you are 10 years ahead, it's 100% more expensive, and you don't want to take the technology 10 years ahead. Maybe 1 year ahead sometimes, maybe sometimes 2 years ahead, especially if you want to have a military tech advantage, you take it earlier than someone else. Otherwise, you don't want to spend your monarch points on a technology that is too far ahead of time. You want to spend your points on development of your provinces, not on paying more for your technology. So, we now have Diplo Tech 4, Military Tech 4, Admin Tech 3 still. And we can now build a marketplace. It's our second building. Forts we had at the beginning, but they're expensive and we already have 2 forts. We can now build a marketplace. And the marketplace gives local trade power plus 50%. So click on it. And here you see the building window for the marketplace. And you can see that some provinces are doing really good and some are not doing good to get more trade power in your home node. Remember the trade node that we were in? The Sevilla trade node? Where we have 51% of our trade power compared to the other countries. And do you also remember that Sevilla with the trade bonuses is our best province? Well, you can see it over here. We have at the moment 33.6 trade power in Sevilla. And when we build the marketplace there, we get 11 more power. When you click on the improvement amount, the game will sort on which provinces give the most bonus. You can see that we only have one good province to build the marketplace, and that is in Sevilla. Gives us 11 more trade power. You can also build buildings by yourself by clicking on a building slot and then click over here. But it is better if you click on the build improvements alert and click on the province and sort on where it's the best province to build the building. I'm going to click here. And now the building will be built in 1 year, and then we will have more trade power in Sevilla. So you want to build your marketplaces on provinces with high base trade power. We have a base of 23 here because of our entrepot and the estuary bonus. So we are going to build marketplace here on Cadiz because we have an extra local trade power base here on Toledo. We're going to build it here, here, and here. Sometimes I build them on my coastal provinces because we have a bit more trade power there, but I don't think they are worthwhile anymore because the effect is very low of the 50%. You want to build them on your bonus provinces. So this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. And then you have more trade power and you get more trade money. Okay, let's go back to the war. See, I'm gonna go to speed 3 now, because otherwise we will have another episode with this war, and that's gonna be a bit long, right? So let's try to win the war here. With speed 3, so it goes a bit quicker. Now we are blockading this port, of course. We cannot blockade Kef, because there's no port in Kef. So there is no -2 penalty. And I think when I have these two forts, I'm going to peace out. Now, we do have a lot of money. Maybe I should build a couple more marketplaces. Now, you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 provinces give 3 more trade power. And the rest lower. These are the provinces where we have the trade bonus. I think I'm going to build the marketplace on all of these provinces. So there we go. Leon, Cantabria, Burgos. You can see in this in the trade map mode that are our base trade provinces that have higher base trade. So we are now building the marketplace on all the provinces where I want them at the moment. And then you are out of your money. And press F for Byzantium. Byzantium is now Constantinia. The Turks have now control over Constantinople. The last remainders of the Roman Empire are now here. Well, this is all Roman Empire, right? Without the Romans, it would not be France and Castile in the first place, but oh well. That's another discussion. Let's see if we can peace out if I have the fort of Kef. Now, I'm not going to take too much land, because if I take a lot of land, one, you get more rebels, and two, you will make the world angry, because you are a warmonger, and they will maybe form a coalition. But I will show you what it is, a coalition. There we go. We have the Siege of Kef. We have 95%. Let's peace out Tunis separately first. Now, I want the province of Tunis. There's a reason for it. Tunis is a level 2 trade power province in the trade node of Tunis. And together with Tripoli and the port we are conquering right now, that are the three most important provinces in this trade node. And if I control these, I get more trade power in this node. And if I would put a merchant transferring trade power to my home node, we can take more money out of here. Now, it's a very not rich node, so we are not going to do it. But I'm still going to take this province here. And I think that's going to be the only province I'm going to take. Now, since this was not a war goal, you have to pay diplo power. We have no claim on this province. So we don't have a reason to take this province. And if you don't have a reason to take the province because you don't have a claim, you pay diplo power. That's a lot, actually, 37. So if I would pick more, for example, the whole state of Tunis. You remember the border, the big border is the state border. You have to pay 133 diplo power. And it's not the only thing. They've also not accept, by the way. They are close, but they won't accept. Then we have to keep going for the war. You also get aggressive expansion. Now, this is a complicated thing, but the more land you take, the more angry the nations around a nation with the same religion and the same culture, I think. No, culture I'm not sure about. The same religion, same continent. They'll become very angry. And if there are three or more, I think three or more, maybe two, but I think three or more countries that have a too much of a aggressive expansion penalty against you, they can form a coalition. And the coalition can kill you. That's another reason why you should not take too much land. So you can see it over here. A coalition may form with this treaty. If I take all of this, Tunis, Togurt, Fezzan, Morocco and Tlemcen will maybe, there's a chance, will join a coalition against me. And then they can go to war with me with five nations against me. That's going to be hard to win. So you need to watch out for the coalition here, the coalition indicator. What I'm going to do is only take Tunis. There's no coalition coming. We pay a little bit of diplo power, but we get a strong province. And I'm going to take all this money. Right click, shift right click, 315. That's a lot of money. Now, is there anything else I can do? I can make Tlemcen big, but why would I? I can make people, I can make Tunis release nations, but we have to pay diplo power for it, so I don't really want to. I can make them annul their treaties with Granada, for example. But why would I? Because I'm going to fully annex Granada, so that doesn't do anything for me. I don't see a war reparation option. Maybe that's another DLC you need. Let me write this down. War reparations. There is a DLC, and then you can do an option here to ask for 10% of their monthly income as war reparations. There's no option right now, so apparently there you need a DLC for this, and I think that's a very helpful demand in a war, so I'm gonna look for which DLC that is. I could ask Tunis to transfer 50% of its trade power to Castile, but they won't accept. So I'm gonna keep the peace offer like this. We take money and we take one province. I'm gonna send the demand. I'm not gonna keep going to war with them. This is more than enough. So send the demand and we win. We got money. Got the money again. We do get in a bit of inflation, but inflation is just a number. Don't worry about it. We pay a bit of diplo power. We are now at minus 6. Get a bit of aggressive expansion, but not too much that people are gonna hate us. And there we go. We now conquered Tunis. I'm gonna send my armies over there. I'm gonna send my fleet over there. I'm gonna wait a couple of days. And then we are gonna peace out Granada. We now have 100%. I'm going to take all their provinces. I'm going to take all their money, otherwise the money will go away because the nation will be destroyed. I can make them lose course, but it doesn't give me anything, so I'm not going to do it. Cannot click on these. Can I make them annul treaties? No, because they will no longer exist. And we cannot do anything over here. This is going to be the peace deal. Now you can see that we might get a coalition. There is a possible coalition between Tunis, Granada, Morocco and Tlemcen. Now the good thing is that Granada will die, so that Tunis, Morocco and Tlemcen will stay there. Who can join a coalition against me? But they can only join a coalition when there is no truce timer. And you can see that over here. We have a truce with Tunis for 10 years, so Tunis cannot join a coalition against us for 10 years. And the negative opinion you get from aggressive expansion will tick down every year. I think I can right click on Tunis. They hate me, minus 81. You can see that the aggressive expansion right now is 26. And this number will go up again with 2.1 yearly. So in 10 years, the aggressive expansion will be lowered by 20. And then they cannot join a coalition anymore because they will go to minus 68. That will be minus 48. And you need minus 50 to join a coalition. So we cannot get a coalition. I think you need three nations and not two. And otherwise we get a coalition of Morocco and Tlemcen. And I think we can beat that. So I'm still going to take all the provinces and the money. Doesn't cost us any diplo power because we had claims on all the provinces. There we go. We won. And now we conquered Southern Coast and we have an extra fort. And we have Tunis. Now I'm going to end the episode here. The war is over. In the next episode I will tell you what you need to do now with the conquered provinces. We can complete our mission. We can now indeed core provinces. That's what we need to do. And we will handle our corruption, because we conquered provinces, you get a bit more corrupt. And we need to deal with that. So that will all happen in the next episode. Please like this video. And I will make a new video maybe tomorrow, because my voice is already dead after 3 episodes because of talking too much. And yeah, hope to see you in the next part. Bye bye.